topic is permutation and combination. Let's see what is permutation first. Permutation is the arranging or set or sequence or order is called permutation. Permutation are classified into two types, linear permutation and circular permutation. First, let's see what is linear permutation formulas. When you ask the number of permutation possible for n items is using this n into n minus 1 into n minus 2, it goes on till 1 or n factorial. You can use this to find the number of permutation possible for n items. And moving to the next, this number of permutation of n different items taken r at a time is denoted by npr. Here comes the formula. Npr is equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial. The other thing is r into n minus 1 into p r minus 1 is the lower term plus n minus 1 pr is the lower term, and this is also npr is equal to, the formula comes like this. These formulas are used when you are asked number of permutations of n different items taken r at a time is denoted by npr. And moving to the next thing is some conditions and formula for linear permutations. Again, you have to know 0 factorial is equal to 1, and the next formula is n minus x into p r minus x is the lower term. What is n? N is the total number of arrangement, r is the things taken at a time, and x is the particular things in particular order. When you are given a question n, r and x, like total number of arrangements are given and things taken at a time and particular things in a particular order is going on, when you are given a question like this, you have to use this formula. N minus x into p r minus x is the lower term. You can substitute all the values so you can get the answer. The similar formula is coming, but a small changes, where here n minus x into p, the formula is n minus x into p, where x is the particular things never occur. Here the particular things in particular order is happening, so the formula comes n minus x into p r minus x. Here n minus x into p, particular things never occur. The next formula is total number of permutation. You are asked to find the total number of permutations when the arrangement of things are not all different, like p will be one kind, q will be another kind, and r will be another kind. You will be given p of some kind of object or item, q of some kind of object, and r of another kind of object. All will be same kind, one kind, but not different. So when you ask this type of question, total number of permutations when the arrangement, when things are not all different, so you have to use the formula n factorial by q factorial, p factorial, q factorial, r factorial. When how many terms are given, it goes on like factorial. You can solve these factorials so you can get the answer to find the total number of permutations. And moving to the next is the circular permutations. Circular permutation is a very simple and common thing, which is circular permutation comes with the word clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangement. It occurs due to clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangement. When these clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangement are different, then this formula is used for number of circular permutation of n different objects is equal to n minus 1 factorial. This formula is used when the clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangement are different for number of circular permutations of n different object. When clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangement are same, then the formula for number of circular permutations of n different object will be n minus 1 factorial divided by 2. The same thing, but when the anti-clockwise and clockwise arrangement are same, it is divided by 2. The next formula is the number of circular permutations of n different object taken r at a time. The formula will be npr by r. Here the formula will be npr divided by 2r. You are adding 2 here. When the clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangements are same, you are adding 2. And for clockwise and anti-clockwise arrangement, when it's different, the formula is NPR by R for number of circular permutations of N different object taken R at a time. Moving to the combinations topic. Combination topics are number of combinations of N dissimilar things taken R at a time is given as NCR. The formula is NCR is equal to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial. I already said you what is R and N. You can substitute the given values and you will find the answer. So the next formula is NCR is equal to NPR by R factorial. The third formula is NCR is equal to NCN minus R. N minus R is the lower term. And the fourth final thing is NCR is equal to NCS. NCR is equal to NCS where R is equal to S or R is equal to N minus S. These formulas are used to find the number of combinations of N dissimilar things taken R at a time. So that's it for the permutation and combination topics. Like, share and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.